Houston Station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground, I'm Isidro Reyna. This week on Station, the crew prepared for an upcoming spacewalk. Two NASA astronauts are scheduled to venture outside the International Space Station for a 6.5-hour spacewalk on May 16th. Expedition 55 flight engineers Drew Feustel and Ricky Arnold have been prepping their spacesuits and reviewing procedures this week for what will be the 210th spacewalk in support of space station assembly, maintenance, and upgrades. The primary objective is to finish upgrading cooling system hardware. Live coverage of the spacewalks will air on NASA TV and NASA.gov. This week, the crew worked on the electrostatic levitation furnace, also known as ELF. ELF is an experimental facility designed to levitate, melt, and solidify materials by containerless processing techniques using the electrostatic levitation method. With this facility, thermophysical properties of high temperature melts can be measured and solidification from deeply undercooled melts can be achieved. The crew exchanged the sample holders and installed a new sample cartridge within ELF to prepare for upcoming ground-commanded operations. Students from Houston area schools spoke to astronauts on the station during an event hosted by Boeing and Space Center Houston. The event was part of NASA's Year of Education on Station. Scott Tingle was asked about the science being conducted on board the ISS.
We have, at any given time, 200 to 250 experiments that are being worked on the International Space Station. But some of the big ones that I've been working on include Apex and Veggie, and they include growing vegetables. We grew lettuce. We're looking at combustion. We're looking at capillary fluids flow. And we're taking part in a lot of human research, such as what happens with our blood, what happens with headaches and fluid shift, and what happens with our bone density and things like that. So lots of stuff going on here, and it's an amazing place to be.
This week's Twitter question comes from Ozzy. He wants to know how astronauts keep track of where they are in space. The station's position, or state in space, is determined by a global positioning system, or GPS receiver, similar to those in a car or a mobile phone. The receiver keeps track of the space station's position and velocity at all points in orbit. Flight controllers in Houston keep track of how the station is oriented and where the sun, Earth, and communication satellites are in reference to the station. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.